Welcome everyone to the video. I put a new website banner up and it says reaching the vision of oneness, and it has some that are examples: Ramana Maharshi, Jesus, Nanda Maima, three really great examples of those who most definitely abided in the vision of oneness. It's possible, even while we're here on this planet, to abide in the vision of oneness, actually. And what I've found is that it's getting clearer and clearer and clearer how easy it is, and whether there will be a rapture to the fifth dimension or ascension or something. Even whether there is or not, even while we're here, we can abide in the vision of oneness. That is definitely possible. So we should try and reach that, because so far there hasn't been any rapture. Now, a lot of Christians believe it's going to happen March 2014, and they have good reason to believe that. A lot of signs point to that. And maybe it will. Maybe it will. Or maybe not. Maybe not. But I do know that after the last several days, I'm ready, because I've seen that this world is simply a hiding place. That's all that it is. And we don't need that hiding place. We simply don't need it. I don't need it. I don't need it anymore. So that just makes ascension, rapture, or whatever, shift into some other place easy, because this is not necessary. This world is it's nothing but a hiding place. A place that's custom designed to seem as though spirit could never be here, couldn't possibly be here. So it's kind of like this Frankenstein God we think we've created is searching the universe. Well, where is my maker? I'm going to destroy my maker. That's the only way I can feel complete, is if I destroy my maker. Where is it? Yeah, and here we are on this planet Earth, and we're feeling relief. Like, oh, wow, it's so great to be here. I love this world. Because surely the God that we believe we created would pass this world by. We wouldn't even bother with it. Wouldn't even give it a second thought. Look at this place and laugh and say, nah, my maker couldn't possibly be hiding out on planet Earth. Or actually any terrestrial domain, but let's just say planet Earth, since we happen to be here. This is the archetype of hiding from what we made, so we don't get annihilated by what we made, because it doesn't feel complete. It doesn't feel that it is prime creator. It feels like something else made it, and that something else is still there. So it must get rid of that something that made it, so it could say, yes, I am God, I am the prime creator. Because if we made it, how could it be God? We would be God, right? To it, at least. So what we projected our will, it wants to destroy its maker. Now, instead of being honest about this whole situation, which we're not honest, we claim that no, it's not our projected will that we thought would be a new God that's trying to destroy its maker. It's the real God that's trying to destroy us, spirit. We project it onto the true God, and then believe the true God is. We need to hide from the true God. Our hiding is from the true God. But we're really hiding from our own projections. But we don't trust the true God to help us, because we've projected this whole thing onto the true God. We don't trust the God of everywhereness, the God of the Holy Spirit. We don't trust that God, because we think, because our projection, we believe it's trying to annihilate us. No, it's our projections that are trying to annihilate us, so that they can be complete and not be something that is merely a derivative or a projection. They say, our projections feel like they're just being projected and they're not actually being created. So they feel if they get rid of their maker, they can claim that then they are free and clear, true creations. This is the terrible bind that we're in, and we're hiding here, pretending that we're human beings dwelling on this planet. Jesus says that in the vision of oneness, the forgiveness is the key. And It says you don't see your brother in spirit anymore as a body. You recognize that they're spirit, not body at all. Body is just a disguise, something that is completely at variance with what we are. So you'd never think that spirit is associated with bodies in any way. No way. No way. But so the vision of oneness is where you see the spiritual quality of everything as primary. And all these bodily disguises, it doesn't matter. And what you see is you see even all these bodies are abiding in the oneness. Even what we've made to completely dissemble what we are and what is in complete variance with our very nature of spirit, even that is abiding in the everywhereness, the perfect plenum. And what it really means is that the nature of God is perfect love, and even the imaginings of spirit are perfectly accepted in by the everywhereness. They dwell in the everywhereness of God. So these pretend puppets we call bodies, those are the imaginings of spirit. And so those are abiding in the everywhereness, the pure spaciousness of everywhereness, just the same as everything is abiding in it. But we realize these are just simply like little puppets that we've made to try and throw our pursuer off the track. But why should we reject these puppets? They are the imaginings of spirit, after all. So if you can view everything that's taking place in this world as merely the action of spirit trying to pretend that it's not spirit, then it changes your outlook, totally changes your outlook, and leads directly to that vision of oneness that we're trying to reach. Now this morning, it was either just as before I got up or just after I got out of bed, I suddenly experienced this sort of a happening. And what it was, in my mind's eye, I saw this amorphous, almost like an octopus like with no set shape. You know, sometimes octopuses move all the tentacles and everything. You can't even tell what is that. You have no idea what it is. And it's all, everything's shifting and changing. It was this amorphous shape that was shifting and changing, and it was inky black, utter blackness. And it was this, and it floated away from me and left me gone. It was the fear complex, the nothing complex, the whole fear nothing the nothing complex, fear complex, delusional complex. This whole complex just left me, and I just let it go. I just just watched it go, and then I said, "Wow, there it goes, gone." So something absolutely vacated me. And it was, again, this very frightening looking, inky black as possible could be, that had no set form or shape, but it was constantly moving and billowing and you know, just trying to that sort of captures the quality of this ego deception. That is constantly shifting with plausibility, trying to always throw some plausibility at you. Now, it is true that we're misperceiving what our problems are. When we're using personality, when we're using perception, sensory perception, which comes from projection, we're misperceiving what our problem is. We're misperceiving it. So all the solutions that we're trying are working on a misperceived problem. We're not working on the right problem at all. So we need the vision of oneness. I'm sorry, we need a reason. In order to reach the vision of oneness, we need a reason. Reason is able to perceive what our problem really is. And it tells us what our problem really is. And it's really the continuity problem. It's not all these other problems at all. Because we're, after all, we're only pretending that we have all these problems. So that this wrathful deity that's trying to destroy its maker will pass us by. Will pass us by. So we're identifying with all these problems and body and world and stuff, and we think that this is us, this is all we are. And we hope that through this identification, this wrathful deity will pass us by and not even be interested in us. So none of this stuff is real. None of the problems are real. It's all concocted entirely. We're just using our skillful creativity and imagination to concoct this cover story, this facade to hide behind. Spirit's hiding behind this facade of a world and bodies, hoping it gets passed by. So there's nothing to fix. It's just realize you don't need to hide anymore. That your this wrathful deity is just a projection, and projections don't leave the mind of the maker, of the one projecting it. So we have complete power over that, and we can just stop projecting. Decide, no, I'm going to accept the vision of oneness and drop this projection. Then there's no wrathful deity trying to destroy you anymore. So you don't need this facade to hide behind. You don't need it. That's it. And so all you have at that point is a continuity problem. You say, wow, I don't need this facade of a world to hide behind, but I've been doing so for so long, I kind of need a soft landing into something else, something different. That's just the continuity problem. This is the only problem we have. And this leaving of the fear complex was directly due to my practicing of the continuity problem. I've been practicing it a lot today. And the realization we don't need this world to hide. We don't need to hide behind this world anymore. The realization has come. So what do you do? Well, you know, you the vision of oneness is seeing the situation as it is, and then realizing that all of this world is just a facade. Seeing past the facade to spirit that's actually doing all this, and then you can forgive everything. You say, oh my gosh, spirit is just so scared. It's producing all of this facade to hide behind. But everybody, so everything you see, every person you see, that is not spirit. It's simply the facade that spirit is using. Whatever body you see, whatever person you see, that is just a facade. That's it. It has nothing to do with spirit. It's totally at variance with what spirit is. So instead of judging one another according to this bodily facade, see past that and see spirit as it is, which you can even see the facade as totally blessed, because it must be, because it comes from spirit. And so you can see this whole world with everybody in it as totally blessed, totally one, and it's just this whole vision of oneness that can dawn upon us. And we will get it for sure, as long as we go along this road. Once we start practicing the continuity problem technique, the vision of oneness is going to dawn upon us. There's no question about it. And my progress has been so rapid, I can't even keep up with it. I don't know what's going to happen next. It's just one day after another. Just the whole fear complex just gone. I said, how do I function without a fear complex? I don't know. We can definitely hone in on the vision of oneness. There is no doubt about it. And we will try to do that going forward for sure. I feel it's going to come in my case. I feel I'm moving into it, actually. When I see people now, I look at them differently. I realize this isn't spirit. This body has nothing to do with what they are. Nothing to do. It's just a device, like a mask they're wearing to try to throw this wrathful deity off track. just a mask. So don't judge the one behind the mask by the mask. It has nothing to do with what's behind the mask, actually. Nothing to do with it. None of these bodies you see in the world have anything to do with what's behind this the mask of a body. So you can just stop judging. You don't need to keep judging. Then when you're willing to drop judgment, then the vision of oneness will dawn. Absolutely. And you realize all these masks don't matter. What's behind the mask is completely divine, completely sacred, and you somehow get the feeling of that. So we will get the vision of oneness for sure going forward. As for who will rapture, who will ascend, who will be saved, all this stuff, well, absolutely you need to see that this world is nothing but a hiding place that you don't need. That's it. It's a hiding place, it's a facade, you don't need it. It's a mask, you don't need the mask anymore. Because you realize what you've done is you've got caught up, you chose a whimsical idea, you got caught up with fear of annihilation, you projected that, you know, and you tried to make a God of your own making to prove that you are greater than God, and this God has been trying to destroy its maker. You project that onto the true God. You're afraid of the true God. All this whole complex of projection, fear, annihilation, whim, you know, all this stuff. You can sort it out. You can see it, and then you just honestly say, "Wow, nothing has changed in reality. Nothing ever happened with reality. Nothing's ever happened to me." All of this stuff is just because I want to be able to create God, be greater than God, or create God. So I try to create God, but it's only a projection, and it hasn't left me at all. It hasn't left my mind at all. So I have power over that, and I can just say no more to that, and it just leaves. I got that Dear John letter and said that this God that I think I created is just, "I'm leaving you. I'm finished. I'm done with you." Of course, it's done with me because I decided to stop, realize it's just a projection. So when you realize it's just a projection, there's no more power over you. And therefore, you're not afraid of it annihilating you. Therefore, you don't need a facade to hide behind, to throw it off the track, throw it off. And so you don't need this wretched, rotting corpse of a world, in a wretched, rotting corpse of a body. You don't need all this facade. You don't need to hide behind that anymore. Absolutely not. And it's just like easy and natural feeling that no, I just don't need that. It's not even an effort or a strain. It's completely obvious. So I cannot predict what's going to happen in my life for sure, because the breakthroughs have been so huge. I don't know what effects they're having. I can't even calculate them. You know, so I don't know what's going to happen next. Some sort of quote unquote enlightenment, that's a term that is used loosely, but I would say vision of oneness is what we're really aiming for. And and that's that you see everything as spirit. Everything that's here is the work of spirit, and behind all these forms and everything is really spirit, which is what I am, what you are. And you recognize it, and there's a recognition there. And since everything is made by spirit and not some alien God, it's all dwelling in God. See, when we believe we created this, a new God, we then believe that this new God was was the one that's making all this stuff. We're worshiping this new God so we don't get annihilated. And we say, wow, new God, look what you did making all this stuff. You made all this stuff. And we think that this, we are the author of it, of all these, this facade, this hiding place. Of course, none of this adds up because it's crazy. You know, we're in this whimsical state. So, of course, you say, how does this align perfectly? It doesn't align perfectly. Because we're doing conflicting things. We're saying we're hiding from this God in this place, and at the same time we're claiming that this God made this place for us. Like, and we're just these. We say, hey God, don't you remember you made us, and we're just these flesh and bones here in this world. That's all we are, which is a great hiding place. We're lying to the Creator God that we think we made. We're lying, saying, no, you made this place. And, you know, you just don't, maybe you don't remember, I don't know, but we're worshiping you, so you must have made it. But you have to understand that it, when fear is in charge, when we're so scared and dishonest, we just try to make things all sorts of different ways and constantly trying to shift things around. But so if everything here was made by this new Creator God that we believe we created, then none of this stuff is abiding in the true God, right? None of it's abiding there. What happens in the vision of oneness is you see that everything is abiding in the one true God, in the true pure spaciousness, which means none of this stuff was made by the new Creator God we think, the Frankenstein God we think, we believe we created. None of it. So everything is saved. Everything, you just realize, everything is mine. It's part of me. It's my imagining, and it's all in God. All this is in God. It wasn't made by some other God. And, well, because we are, whatever we make or create or even imagine is in God, okay? Always. So it's all in God. I think this is the amazing insight that I saw. It was so happy. Oh my gosh, there is no other God. There's only one God. There isn't another one. And everything is abiding in the pure spaciousness, the eternal life of the one God. All our imaginings, all our facade, all our set, everything we did to hide, this whole world we made, and all the bodies we made, and everything, it's all abiding in the one true God perfectly, totally supported and permeated, saturated and permeated by pure spaciousness. And that's just like the fantastic relief. It's such good news, you can't even express it or describe it, really. And I saw that, and I saw, wow, that's such great news. I'm going to have to think about that a little bit first. it's just like, there's just this tremendous great news just waiting for us. That, I can tell you 100% for sure that's a fact. There's this tremendous news that is so great, and it just keeps on. The welcomeness of that news just keeps on going and going and going. It is such welcome news. Nothing separate. There is no separateness whatsoever. It's not like there are some things that we made and some things that this new God made and it's all mixed up together, integrated, and nothing like that. No. There is absolutely nothing made by some other God. It is all from Spirit. All our imaginings, and yet it's all from us. There's nothing separate. Nothing separate. Nothing mixed. Nothing mixed up whatsoever. Completely pure. Completely immaculate. Completely pure. In a sense, we made it. We're imagining it. We're not stuck in it. are we? So there's this amazing great news for all of us, right close, you know, very close at hand. So I totally expect at some point it will dawn upon me, but it better be soon. It just better be soon, because my external circumstances are absolutely terrible. Doomsday type of, you know, external scenario, actually. But being that I'm always on time, I imagine this. I would say this vision of oneness will dawn in the nick of time, and somehow circumstances will shift. See, we're trying to worship this God. We think we created a new God, and it's trying to destroy us. But by being these bodies worshiping this God, we're trying to say, God, we're your devotees. We're not spirit. We're your devotees. You made us. We're worshiping you. You can't destroy us. Why would you want to destroy us? You see? So we're frantic to believe that this God, Frankenstein God, that we is just a projection of our will, made all this stuff. Even though, rightfully so, this Jesus, they say Jesus, the Son of God, which is Spirit, Son of God, actually is the maker of this universe, maker of all this stuff. Well, that is true. We are Spirit. We're the makers of all this. We're the makers of our hiding place. God didn't make, the true God didn't say, hey, you're in great danger, you need to have hiding places. No. We fashion this hiding place. We fashion these bodies, and now we pretend to be great devotees of this Frankenstein God, and say, you can't. And we say, you made all this stuff. We're here worshiping you. Look at your great works. Awesome. Unbelievable what you've done. And we hope to save our necks by that. But when we recognize that this is all what we did, and that other God did nothing at all, then how can it could be a God? It's not a God. It's a projection. And there are no works by this other God. There are no works by this other God. And in fact, these works do reflect somewhat upon the true God, because we, Spirit, are the ones that are imagining them, you see. So it's like a beautiful homecoming, a beautiful recognition. The most welcome news possible that, wow. So we'll just take it a day at a time, and I really don't know what's going to happen next. I've been given some foreshadowing. It's good foreshadowing, for sure. But you just don't know. I didn't expect this inky black blob of fear and nothingness to suddenly depart from me. Flee from me. It fled from me, actually. What I'm finding out is all these complexes we have of deception. Once you get more and more clear and do the continuity techniques, I don't have a fear complex problem. I don't have that problem anymore. I don't have it at all. There is no fear complex problem. There's only the continuity problem. You insist upon that. These complexes flee from you. They leave you. They leave on their own accord. You don't have to battle with them to get rid of them. They just take off. They can't stand you anymore. That's what's happened for me. I spent my whole life battling with these complexes, trying to force them to leave. And now instead I just use the continuity technique and insist I don't have that problem. I only have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. I don't have any other problem whatsoever. These other problems have zero value for me. Insist upon it. And these complexes just flee, head for the hills. They just want to get away from me as fast as possible. No, I don't have to do anything. I don't have to push them away or anything. They take off on their own accord. They said, we don't have anything to do with you anymore. We're finished with you. And I said, good, good riddance. Great. Goodbye, good riddance. Just let them go. Don't chase after them. I think I've had at least 3 instances of that happen now. So the continuity technique is simply to say, I don't have a blackmail problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a collection problem. I don't need to collect anything from anybody. I don't need to try and collect dues, copyright dues, fees, somebody owing me something. I don't need to try to blackmail people through fear to pay me and get more collection. I don't have a collection problem. I only have a continuity problem. I don't have a blackmail problem. I only have a continuity problem. The blackmail problem has zero value to me. My only problem is the continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. See? I don't have a fear complex problem. I only have a continuity problem. So just work on those complexes and deny that you have them. Say, I don't have it. I only have a continuity problem. That's it. Be very adamant about it. And these complexes will just feel that they're totally unwelcome now, and they will leave you without you having to argue with them at all. Argue them away or force them away or, struggle. No struggle. They just leave on their own. And of course, you just got to let them go. You just say, I'm not going to chase after them. Just let them go. And keep practicing. And as you keep practicing, they won't come back. They will not come back. They're not welcome anymore. Because you don't have that problem. You don't have an ego problem. I don't have an ego problem. I only have a continuity problem. I don't have a wrathful deity problem. I only have a continuity problem. That's the only problem I have. And the vision of oneness solves that problem. So, I have no interest in any other problems. These other problems have zero value. Ego problem has zero value to me. Fee collection has zero problem, has zero value to me. Fear complex problem has zero value to me. No value. No value, none. Only the continuity problem has value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value. It resolves the continuity problem. I would say if everybody in the world did this continuity exercise, and did it vigorously and adamantly, in a matter of months or so, people would be enlightened. All the complexes would leave. Gone. There would be peace in the world. No question about it. These complexes cannot withstand this practice. They cannot. Because you're denying, you have no interest, zero interest in them anymore. I don't have that problem. And you put it in the now. I don't have that problem. I only have the continuity problem. Right now, talking about right now, I don't have any of those problems. I don't have an ego problem. I don't have a life problem. I don't have a security problem. Nothing except the continuity problems. The only problem I have, no other problems. Right now, no other problems, just that one problem. And this just cuts the oxygen off from these complexes. It just cuts it off. And they flee, have to leave. They just take off. They say, I can't stand the oxygen. I can't stand the atmosphere here anymore. Yeah. And you just relentlessly on that. You don't engage the complexes at all. You don't argue with them. You don't explain anything to them. Don't discuss anything. You just say, I don't have that problem. Because it's true. We don't. We only have a continuity problem. We're hiding from a non-existent wrathful deity. We're hiding from nothing, really. There is no wrathful deity. There's wrathful projections. But those are still in our... Those get their power from our own desire to be greater than God. When we decide to repent, then we don't have to project, make these projections. And the projections just are deflated. They're totally deflated. And then they flee from us. So I don't have a projection problem. I only have I only have one problem, it's the continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. Be very insistent on this. Your will is just focused. That is it. This is your will. You're expressing your will. You know, this is my will. This is my will. I do not have a wrathful deity problem. I only have a continuity problem. That's my only problem. The wrathful deity problem has zero value to me. No value. Only the vision of oneness has value. And you just keep using that technique. I don't have this, you know, problem. The only problem that I have is the continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem I have. And then you say, this problem, this wrathful deity problem, has zero value to me. Zero value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Only the vision of oneness. The vision of oneness is the only value that there is. And just keep doing that technique. It's a very simple technique. I don't have a wrathful deity problem. I do not have any wrathful deity problem whatsoever. The only problem that I have is the continuity problem. I only have one problem. See, I don't have a wrathful deity problem. I only have one problem, and it's the continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem I have. The wrathful deity problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value. Completely deflating the wrathful deity problem, completely deflating it, and it will then take off from you, leave you, depart from you. What did Jesus say? Get behind me, Satan, depart from me, right? Just using the will. I see no value in you whatsoever, which is, of course, talking about our projections. I see no value in those projections whatsoever. So depart, they depart. I have to depart. Poof, you know, poof. The complex goes off and dwindles away into nothing. Like the snake seems to depart, go away, and there's the rope. Where's the snake? I don't know. It just sort of vanished, faded off and vanished somewhere. We don't have to argue with the snake to leave because it's not there, it's the rope. So you say, I don't have a snake problem. I don't have a snake problem. I only have a continuity problem. I don't have a snake problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a snake problem. I have a continuity problem. That's the only problem I have. I don't have a snake problem. I have one problem, and it's the continuity problem. That's the only problem that I have. Say that. I don't have a snake problem. The only problem that I have is the continuity problem. I don't have a snake problem. The only problem I have is the continuity problem, and the vision of oneness solves the continuity problem. The snake problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. So you don't argue with the snake. You don't try to convince the snake to leave. You don't try to discuss anything with the snake. Don't try to chase it away. You just say you don't have that problem. And I don't have a snake problem. I have no snake problem whatsoever. Don't have it. And one day, it will seem as if the snake suddenly takes off, gone, and there's the rope, you see. Gone. The snake is gone. It was never there. But because we believed in it so much, we think we see it leave. We think we see it leaving. It's really the belief complex of the snake that held the snake in place leaves. You see that leave. And then there's just the rope in you, and you say, ah. And then you realize vision of oneness. That rope is your own imagination. You're imagining that rope. And therefore it abides in the pure spaciousness of God, along with the dirt, the path, the trail, the trees, people, everything. Everything. That's the vision of oneness. So don't argue with your problems. Just deny them entirely. and insist that you do have a continuity problem. I do have a continuity problem. It's the only problem that I have. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. I don't have a snake problem. I have a continuity problem. See? You can do it that way. But it's the only problem that I have. I don't have any other problem. I don't have a wrathful deity problem. I only have a continuity problem. The wrathful deity problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value. So this is exactly the technique that I use. Exactly the technique. I have a continuity problem. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem that I have. I have a severe continuity problem, yes. I don't have any other problem. The fee collecting problem has zero value to me. I don't have a fee collecting problem. I have a continuity problem. The fee collecting problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value. Just like that. Just like that. And don't, again, get in arguments with the imaginary snake about how valuable this technique is. The snake says, is it working? How do you think it's working? Maybe it's working. And how's it going so far? Don't get in any discussions with it like that. Just do it. And use your will. All of our thoughts are blocked out. You're just stating fact. That's all. Just state fact. State the fact. State the fact. And the complex will flee of its own accord from you without you having to do anything else. I won't have to push it out. It will go. It will just leave you. Of course, we call this super advanced technique, but what it really is effective technique. And we call it super advanced because it's effective. It's just that the other stuff isn't effective. So it's just what works. The arguing doesn't work. The discussion doesn't work. The attempt to outsmart it doesn't work, because you're thinking that you do have that problem, but you're trying to solve it somehow. Now, to say you don't have the problem, so there's nothing to work on. There's nothing to work on. I don't have the ego complex problem, so zero value to me. And then just say, I have a continuity problem. That's the only problem I'm working on. It's the only problem I have. I'm totally focused on the continuity problem. And so, no, zero interest in any ego problem. You don't have an ego problem. And the ego problem will say, gee, I guess I don't exist here. Flee from you. That's what happens. That is what happens. But, of course, the ego will never tell us about this technique. For sure, it will have us pursuing infinite other techniques. You know, some way to defeat it, some way to get rid of it, some way to integrate it, some way to kill the ego, some this and this, whatever. But to simply deny, this pure denial, say, I don't have that problem. But I have a continuity problem, therefore I'm completely focused on solving that problem. That's it for all these complexes. Finishes them off. Of course, some of us may not want to finish them off yet, right? Yet, so that's fine. If you don't want to finish them off yet, that's fine. They'll stay with you until you feel like you want them to leave. But of course, this imaginary wrathful God that we think we created didn't make any of this stuff. So it's all our stuff. It's all abiding in the pure spaciousness of God. We are home, essentially. We are home, essentially. We really never left. And so you just experience this total sacredness, blessedness of everything. That's the vision of oneness. So that's what's waiting for us. The payoff is tremendous. The news is super welcome news. Best news you could ever have. Best news. We talk about all the bad news in the world now. I'm trying not to pay any attention to it anymore. I don't care about anything that's happening in the world one way or the other. Really, it's not important, because I only have a continuity problem. I don't have those problems. And the good news is there. I saw it. The good news is there. The best, is such great news that obliterates all the bad news of the world. Obliterates it. Gone. Totally gone. There's no more bad news. Once you see the vision of oneness, it dawns upon you and you abide in it. There is no such thing as bad news. The good news is so great, it completely trumps whatever bad news, the feeble bad news the world can generate. Completely trumps it. Because nothing that we think is happening is really happening at all. There is no other God. There's only one God. There is no other wrathful deity God, you know, and may having made all this stuff and put us here as bodies and making us worship. And there is no such thing. That everything is sacred because everything is dwelling in the one true God. Already, always has been. And doesn't matter what lives or dies, form-wise, whatever, everything is dwelling in here. And we made these temporary forms, so they seem temporary, but it no longer affects us in the slightest bit. The coming and going of forms. This is all just our disguise, and everything is always abiding in the oneness of God, the one pure spaciousness of God. And it just, it's such good news, you just have to sit there quietly just to abide in it. The good news is just pure good news. The purity of it is what is so astonishing, so wonderful. Absolute purity of it. Absolute purity of good news. Okay. So we will continue to reaching the vision of oneness. That's what we're doing. We're reaching the vision of oneness here. And we're doing it. It's right there now. It's just, you know, ready to dawn. Absolutely ready to dawn here. Okay. All right. Very great. Thanks for watching the video. And we'll see what tomorrow brings. I just don't know. Never know. Probably it's going to be something significant for sure. All right. That's it.